Good morning, church. Today is a great day to praise the Lord. Let's be thankful to Him for all He has done. God is good and His love endures forever. Amen. Last week we just celebrated Mother's Day. And next month we're going to celebrate Father's Day. Time flies, doesn't it? We are almost half year going. Day by day, night by night, we all made it through. It's all because of Him who strengthen us, that we all can make it here today. Amen? God is good. 2 weeks ago, I preached about finding the right focus. I mentioned that we should stop complaining and comparing, and we should be joyful, be grateful, and be prayerful. And we should not underestimate the power of prayer. Because prayer is not about us. Prayer is about giving space to God to do His way and His will upon our life. And today, and for the next 2 weeks, I'm going to preach a new sermon series that is called Breakthrough, Not Breakdown. Breakthrough, Not Breakdown. Let me start with this. God is sovereign over all things in this world. Whether you are doing fine right now, or maybe some of you are dealing with hardship, God knows. God knows. And we should also be aware that Satan, the devil, is not sitting still, no matter what your situation is. The devil is at work, trying to deceive us, trying to destroy our life, to destroy our marriage, our family, to destroy our relationship, our career, our business, stealing our peace, stealing our joy, giving us fear. And then he misleads us to the wrong things and getting us away from the Lord. The devil, Satan, is at work no matter what. So we should be aware of it. He doesn't want us to have a breakthrough, but He wants us to have a breakdown in our life, breakdown in our spirit, breakdown in our soul, breakdown in our mental emotion, breakdown in our life. So church, let's open our eyes, let's open our heart, that be aware that Satan is also at work trying to destroy our life. 3 weeks ago, I got a dream. In that dream, I saw there was a snake and three chickens at the back of my house, at my patio. The snake tried to sneak in under the patio door, wanted to come into inside my house, but it couldn't make it. However, in that dream, I saw that the first chicken was about to die. The first chicken is dying because the snake just snapped it. I saw that the first chicken was laying down. It could not walk. It could not make any sound. It could not move at all. Crippled, numb, and dying because of the venom. And the second chicken was about to get snapped from behind. And I saw the third chicken was running away before it got snapped. And after that, I woke up and then I prayed. And then I realized that I should pray for divine protection and speak against the devil, the evil spirit who is trying to attack us. I pray for my family. I pray for the church. I pray to God for protection, for divine protection upon every one of us from the enemy attacks, from the venom that the devil is trying to, to snap our life, that make us crippled, numb, cannot move, break down. So that's what I pray. After I got that dream, I asked the Lord for protection for every one of us, for the church, for my family. And on the next day, God gave me a scripture, and I want to share it to you today. Breakthrough, not breakdown. Breakthrough, not breakdown. Let's open our Bible from Mark chapter 9, verse 14 to 29. Mark chapter 9, verse 14 to 29. I'm going to read it from New Living Translation. When they returned to the other disciples, they saw a large crowd surrounding them, and some teachers of religious law were arguing with them. When the crowd saw Jesus, they were overwhelmed with awe and they ran to greet him. Verse 16. What is all this arguing about? Jesus asked. One of the men in the crowd spoke up and said, Teacher, I brought my son so you could heal him. He is possessed by an evil spirit that won't let him talk. I repeat again. He is possessed by an evil spirit that won't let him talk. And whenever the spirit sees him, it throws him violently to the ground. Then he foams at the mouth and grinds his teeth and becomes rigid. So I asked your disciples to cast out the evil spirit, but they couldn't do it. Verse 19, Jesus said to them, You faithless people, how long must I be with you? How long must I put up with you? Bring the boy to me. So they brought the boy. But when the evil spirit saw Jesus, it threw the child into a violent convulsions, and he fell to the ground, writhing and foaming at the mouth. How long has this been happening? Jesus asked the boy's father. He replied, since he was a little boy, the spirit often threw him into the fire and into water, trying to kill him. Have mercy on us and help us if you can. What do you mean, if I can? Jesus asked. Anything is possible if a person believes. The father instantly cried out, I do believe, but help me overcome my unbelief. When Jesus saw that the crowd of onlookers was growing, he rebuked the evil spirit. Listen, you spirit that makes this boy unable to hear and speak, he said. I command you to come out of this child and never enter him again. Then the spirit screamed and threw the boy into another violent convulsion and left him. The boy appeared to be dead. A murmur ran through the crowd as people say, he is dead. But Jesus took him by the hand and helped him to his feet, and he stood up. Verse 28, afterward, when Jesus was alone in the house with his disciples, they asked him, why couldn't we cast out that evil spirit? Jesus replied, this kind can be cast out only by prayer. From Matthew chapter 9 verse 17, we could see that the evil spirit won't let the boy talk. It means the boy could talk, but the evil spirit inside of him won't let him talk. And it's verse 25, Jesus knew that the evil spirit was the one who made the boy unable to hear and speak. The devil had been trying since in the beginning to destroy our life by making us unable to hear and speak. The snake is trying to snap us with a venom, make us crippled and numb, immovable. In other words, the devil wants us to have a breakdown. When I got this message, it is not referring to being unable to hear and speak physically, but unable to hear and speak spiritually and mentally. The devil is trying to make us numb, crippled, blind, deaf, in spirit, in our soul, that we cannot communicate with God, we cannot hear God's voice, and we cannot communicate, we don't know how to communicate with others. He is trying to make us numb, immovable, disable us from speaking and hearing in our spirit. The devil wants us to have a breakdown mentally, emotionally, spiritually, and also breakdown in our communication and in our listening, in our relationship, maybe in our marriage life between husband and wife, or in our family between parents and the children, and also among believers in our church life. So we could see that that's what is Satan trying to do, destroying our life, our relationship, our communication, our hearing, in our spirit, socially, in our soul, mentally, emotionally. It's the same as what the story said. The boy could talk, but the evil spirit inside of him that make him unable to speak and hear. The devil wants us to have a breakdown in our life. But God wants us to have a breakthrough. That's a good news. Amen? Breakthrough, not breakdown. Today, I'm preaching about breakthrough in our speaking. And next week, I will preach about breakthrough in our listening. Let me ask you with these questions. For those who are married, how's your communication going with your spouse? Are you been hiding something from your spouse? Is there any open communication? Is there any a deep communication? Have you given yourself to listen to what your spouse have been sharing to you? And next, for those who have family, how's your communication going with your parents or maybe with your kids? Have you given your time to listen to what they want to share from their hearts? For some of us, this current situation should be giving us more family time together. That's a good one, isn't it? Beside all this situation that we are having right now, but there's always a good thing that we can spend time more with family, maybe with your friends more. Maybe you can improving or develop yourself more. And the next one, for those who are in relationship, how's your communication going with your partner? Have you been open and be yourself to him or to her? How well do you know your partner? And for those who are professionals, how's your communication going with your co-workers and your supervisor? Have you given your best in communicating and listening on what you need to do in your career, in your business? And now, how about with those who are called as Christian or believers? How is your communication going with God? Do you pray? Do you read your Bible? Is there any passion inside of us wanting to know Him better? Do you listen what God says to you, or can you listen what He says? So how's your communication going? How's your prayer life with God? We should be aware. Don't let Satan try to make us, disable us in speaking and hearing, in our spirit, in our emotion, in our soul. God wants us to have a breakthrough, not breakdown. Do you know that communication is the main thing in any relationship? Relationship with God and relationship with others. Communication is the main thing. When there is no communication in a relationship, there would be assumption and misunderstanding in it. And when communication gets breakdown, there would be confusion. And when there's a confusion in relationship, there would be no connection. So when there is no communication, there would be a confusion. And when there is a confusion in a relationship, there won't be any connection in that relationship. Mark chapter 9 verse 21. Let's go back again to Mark chapter 9 verse 21. How long has this been happening? Jesus asked the boy's father. He replied, since he was a little boy. We could see that there is no communication between the boy and his father since he was little. Can you imagine that? How desperate the father was, wanted to have a communication with his own son. And that's what the devil wants. He wants to destroy the communication in the family. He wants to destroy a relationship by disable the boy, that he was unable to speak and to hear. So the father has been looking for a communication relationship with his own son. But the evil spirit inside the boy that make him unable to speak and to hear. The devils wants us to have a breakdown in any relationship, in any aspect of our life. He doesn't want us to have a breakthrough, but the good news is God wants us to have a breakthrough, and God is able to restore all the things that has been broken. So church, God is good. There's always a reason and a purpose. And there's always a moment why Jesus was there at that time. Because He cared so much for our family. He cares so much for you and I. So that we can be free in speaking, in listening what God is trying to say to us. God wants us to live in freedom, not in a bondage. Because He came to give us life is abundance. He doesn't want us to be living in a bondage that we cannot move, crippled, numb, deaf, blind. God wants to reveal something to us so that we can move on. That's what I call breakthrough. And God can restore the things that have been broken in your life and in my life. Let's believe that God is able. Amen. God is able. Let's continue. Mark chapter 9, verse 21 to 24. Let's read it again. How long has this been happening? Jesus asked the boy father. He replied, since he was a little boy, the spirit often threw him into the fire and into water, trying to kill him. Have mercy on us and help us if you can. What do you mean if I can? Jesus asked. Anything is possible if a person believes. The father instantly cried out, I do believe, and help me overcome my unbelief. So can you see here, church? Jesus can restore the things that has been broken in our life as long as you believe. So don't be discouraged. Don't get misled by the devil that's trying to attack our inner being, telling us to giving up everything. There's no hope and there's nothing that you can do, and so on. But keep on believing what God says to us, that God is able to open up the way when there seems to be no way. There's always a hope. God wants us to have a breakthrough. But the devil wants us to have a breakdown. And the good news is God can restore all the things that's been broken as long as you believe. As long as I believe. That's why, church, keep on trusting the Lord. Keep having our faith stronger in the Lord. Keep on believing that God can restore things. God is able to make all things new. Amen. As long as you believe, anything is possible if you believe and if I believe. God is able. God is able. There are so many ways that we can communicate. Through speaking, talking, and body language, sign language, by texting nowadays. Everything is by virtual texting. Through the eyes is the window of the heart. And tears also is a language. And silence. Now, not every silence means there is no communication. Unable to speak and being silenced in the right moment is different. Unable to speak means you cannot speak even though you want to speak. But being silent is a non-verbal communication, and you can say a lot by saying nothing. Proverbs chapter 10 verse 19 says, you will say the wrong things if you talk too much. So be sensible and watch what you say. In communicating, we should know what to say, how to say it, when to say it, and where to say it. Proverbs 25, verse 11 says, the right word at the right time is like precious gold set in silver. So church, be careful with our words. We should know what to say, we should know how to say, and we should know when to say it and where to say it. Why the devil wants to disable us in our speaking? Have you ever questioned yourself? Ask yourself with that. Questions. Why the devil wants to disable us in our speaking? Because there's a power in our words. Because there's a power in our words. Proverbs 18 verse 21 says, the tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. Mark chapter 11 verse 23, if you have faith in God and don't doubt, you can tell. I repeat again, if you have faith in God and don't doubt, you can tell this mountain to get up and jump into the sea, and it will. So there's a power in our mouth. I want to show it to you what Jesus say at the end of the story in Mark chapter 9 verse 29. Okay, from Mark chapter 9 verse 29. Let's see what Jesus say at the end of this story. Jesus replied, "This kind can be cast out only by prayer." Only by prayer. The devil knows the power of prayer. That's why the devil is trying hard to disable our prayer life, to disable our hearing and speaking for the Lord's voice, to hearing God's voice. That the devil wants to disable us, to bringing us away from the prayer life, from our communication with God. So the devil is trying hard to mislead us, to give us many distractions, so we won't be able to bring ourselves to God, to talk to God, to pray to God. So that's what I call breakdown in our prayer life, breakdown in our spirit, breakdown in our emotion, breakdown in our mental life, in our life, in social life. The devil is trying to destroy our life by giving us breakdown in all areas of our life. But God is giving us breakthrough. And one of them is by prayer. The devil knows there's a power when we talk to God. The devil knows there's a power when we speak against Him. The devil knows there's a power in the prayer. So that's what I got from the dream that I had 3 weeks ago. That the snake is trying to kill, to disable the first chicken there. So the dream gives us a message that we should be aware. Okay? Let's continue. So how do we want to see a breakthrough in our speaking, in our communication? So how do we want to see a breakthrough? Number one, when you talk to God, talk openly and genuinely. Okay, when we talk to God, talk openly and genuinely. Don't play words with God, because God looks what is in our heart. So then don't play words with God, because God sees, God knows, God looks what is in our hearts. Philippians chapter 4 verse 6 says, "Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need." So talk openly. Tell God what you need. Just don't play words with Him. Just what is your need? Just tell God. Tell God what you need and thank Him for all He has done. Matthew chapter 6 verse 7. "And when you are praying, do not use meaningless repetition as the Gentiles do, for they suppose that they will be heard for their many words." Talk genuinely. "And when you're praying, do not use meaningless repetitions." Just tell what you need. So, how do we want to see a breakthrough in our speaking, in our communication with God? Talk openly and talk genuinely. Tell God what you need. Don't use meaningless repetition. Just express what is in your heart. What is your need? Sometimes words cannot be a good way to express, because sometimes the emotion is more than words, because it's all about what is going on within us, in our soul, in our mind, that words are limited. Once again, there's so many ways that we can communicate with God, and God knows everything that you are going through. God knows what's in your mind. God knows what is in your heart. Maybe we cannot express it. We don't know how to express it by words, but God knows. Even God knows and understands your tears. God is good. Amen. Just talk openly. Talk genuinely with God. That's number one, when you talk to God. Talk openly and genuinely. Number two, when you speak against the devil. How do you want to see a breakthrough in our speaking when we speak against the devil? Speak with the authority and speak with the word of God. Speak with the authority and speak with the word of God. Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Luke chapter 10, verse 19. I've given you the power to trample on snakes and scorpions and to defeat the power of your enemy, Satan. Nothing can harm you. I repeat again. When you speak against the devil, speak with the authority. I've given you the power to trample on snakes and scorpions and to defeat the power of your Satan enemy. Nothing can harm you. The next one, when you speak against the devil, speak with the word of God. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 17. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 17. A final word, be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Put on all of God's armor so that you will be able to stand firm against all the strategy of the devil. For we are not fighting against flesh and blood enemies, but against evil rulers and authorities of the unseen world, against mighty powers in this dark world, and against evil spirits in the heavenly places. Therefore, put on every piece of God's armor so you will be able to resist the enemy in the time of evil. Then after the battle, you will still be standing firm. Stand your ground, putting on the belt of truth and the body armor of God's righteousness. For shoes, put on the peace that comes from the good news so that you will be fully prepared. Verse 16. In addition to all of this, hold up the shield of faith to stop the fiery arrows from the devil. Verse 17, put on salvation as your helmet and take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. So when we speak against the devil, speak with the authority and speak with the word of God. So read your Bible. Meditate day and night. Because this is not just only a book, but this is the book of life. This is God Himself. And this is the sword that we can be able to resist the devil. Speak against him with the authority and with the power, with the word of God. Amen? That's number two. How do you want to see breakthrough in our speaking against the devil? Speak with the authority and speak with the word of God. And number three, when we communicate with others, talk honestly and respectfully. How do you want to see a breakthrough in our speaking with other people, with others? Talk honestly and respectfully. Say what you mean and mean what you say. Some people cannot enjoy their life because they don't say it honestly. Telling lies will lead them to another lies, and it will haunt them wherever they are. Telling lies will set you into fear. But telling truth will set you free. Telling lies will set you into fear, and telling truth will set you free. 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 10 says, if you want to enjoy life and see many happy days, keep your tongue from speaking evil and your lips from telling lies. So, how do we want to see breakthrough in our speaking, our communication with other people, with others? Speak honestly. Say what you mean what you say. Stop telling lies. Telling lies will set you into fear. Telling truth will set you free. Let's open Matthew chapter 5, verse 37. Matthew chapter 5, verse 37. Just say a simple yes, I will, or no, I won't. Anything beyond this from the evil one. Can you see it here? If it's yes, say yes. If it's no, say no. Anything beyond this, beside this, comes from the evil one. It means anything beside this is all lies. So church, when we talk, when we communicate with others, talk honestly. Okay? And the next one, talk respectfully. Talk respectfully. Respectful saying comes from careful thinking. I repeat again. Respectful saying comes from careful thinking. It is better to think first before we say, because words is powerful. Proverbs 15 verse 28a, it says, the heart of the godly thinks carefully before speaking. Proverbs 18 verse 21 says, words kill, words give life. They are either poison or fruit. You choose. The food we put into our mouth doesn't make us unclean and unfit to worship God. The bad words that comes out of our mouth are what make us unclean. So when we talk with others, make sure we talk respectfully. It can be applied in your marriage life, in your family life, when you talk with your spouse, how you talk with your spouse, how you talk with your parents, how you talk with your kids, how you talk with other people, how you talk with your friends, how you talk with your supervisor, how you talk with God. So when we talk with other people, talk honestly and talk respectfully. Be careful how to use the word always and never in our relationship. So remember, respectful saying comes from careful thinking. Respectful saying comes from careful thinking. Let's open our Bible to Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. Do not use foul or abusive language. Let everything you say be good and helpful, so that your words will be an encouragement to those who hear them. So when we talk, how do we wanna have a breakthrough in our speaking, our communication with other people? Talk honestly and talk respectfully. So church, let's pray for a breakthrough. Believing that God is able to restore things that has been broken in our life. Maybe some of you are struggling right now with yourself, in your prayer life. You don't know how to talk to God, and you don't know what to say. You don't know how to express what's inside your heart. Or maybe you have some struggling with a situation in the family, in your communication, in your relationship with friends, or maybe with your spouse, remember this. Be careful that Satan, the devil, is destroying our life by making us disabled to speak and to hear with God and with one another. And God doesn't want that to be happening in our life. God wants us to have a breakthrough. And God is able to restore things. Let us open the last scripture from Exodus chapter 4. Exodus chapter 4, verse 11 to 12. I want to close with this one scripture. Exodus chapter 4, verse 11 to 12. Then the Lord asked Moses, "Who makes a person's mouth? Who decides whether people speak or do not speak? Hear or do not hear? See or do not see? Is it not I, the Lord? Now go, I will be with you as you speak, and I will instruct you in what to say." As God led Moses in what to say, I believe God also leads us in what to say. God will be with you as you speak. Amen. Same thing what God said to Moses, I will be with you as you speak. God will be with you. God will be with us as we speak. And God will instruct us, God will instruct you in what to say. So church, let's start to build up a communication in our speaking. When we talk to God, talk openly and genuinely. And when we speak against the devil, speak with the authority and speak with the word of God. And when we communicate with others, communicate, talk honestly and respectfully. And when you believe, anything is possible. Amen? Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I want to thank you for your word for today. I believe you can restore all the broken things that happen in our life. I believe you can heal all the wounds that we have in our hearts. So Lord, I want to pray for those who want to start to have a conversation with you for the first time. And those who want to start again on their prayer life with you, that there will be new desire and hunger within them, longing for you, Lord. As your word says in Jeremiah chapter 29, when we pray, God will listen. And when we look for you wholeheartedly, we will find you. So I speak breakthrough for our prayer life, that there will be vision and dream, godly revelation and awakening in our spirit. And Lord, I also want to pray to those who are looking for a restoration in the communication in their relationship, maybe in their marriage life between husband and wife, maybe in their family life between parents and children, or maybe in their relationship with others. I pray and then I speak breakthrough, that there will be healing, forgiveness, openness and understanding among them. Give them wisdom in what to say, how to say and when to say. Thank you, Lord. And lastly, I speak with the authority from the Lord Jesus Christ to speak against the devil who is trying to destroy our life, our family, our relationship, our career, our business, our city, our community, our nation. Together we speak against the devil to go away in Jesus' name. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. When God is for us, nothing can against us. In Jesus' name, everybody say, Amen. Amen. God bless you all. Have a great weekend. I'll see you again next week. Bye-bye.